Alone a woman struggles to free her husband from the claws of tyranny. Here, there, anywhere. Now, then, tomorrow. The setting may change, but the struggle remains. Always there is injustice. Always there is indifference. But there is also always courage and hope. The one hope of the persecuted, freedom. Chained below, the prisoners. Lounging above, their jailers. The age-old story. Now, being a jailer is not too bad. You earn decent money, you sit in the sun, you chat, you daydream. You don't bother much about those down below. They are criminals, aren't they? Besides, you've got your own problems. Take Marcelina, for instance. She is the daughter of the prison warden, Rocco. For weeks, that fresh young porter, Giacchino, has been after her to marry him. Him, a little nobody. But Marcelina is no fool. She knows an attractive fellow when she sees one, like Fidelio, the new man who has just started working for her father. He has changed everything.
Schätzchen, jetzt sind wir allein. Wir können vertraulich zu Namen.
Es wird ja nichts Wichtiges sein. Ich darf bei der Arbeit nicht zögern.
Ein Wörtchen, du trotzige Du.
So sprich nur, ich höre dir zu. Ich höre dir zu. Ich höre dir zu.
Wenn du mir nicht freundlich erblickst, so bring ich kein Wörtchen hervor.
Wann wirst
du das Jahr von mir geben? es könnte ja heute noch sein.
Oh, wie verbittert mein Leben, jetzt, morgen und immer. Und immer und immer, nein, nein, und immer, nein, 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 nein.
Du bist doch verhaftet von
Schande.
Du siehst ja verhaftet
jetzt
von Schande.
Jetzt, morgen und immer.
Ein Mädchen kann beten, kann beten, kann beten, nicht mein. So wirst du dich nimmer, nimmer bekehren. Was meinst du?
Du könntest nun gehen.
Wie? Dich anzusehen. Dich anzusehen, dich anzusehen, willst du mir wehren? Auch das noch,
so bleibe
auch das noch. Du hast mir so oft du versprochen.
Versprochen? Nein, das geht so weit, das geht so weit.
Thank you.
Fidelio, the young man Marcellina so fancies, is a fraud. He is really a woman who has disguised herself in desperation. Just a few years ago, Leonora and her husband Don Florestan were living together contentedly. He was a man with an uncommon addiction to the truth. Now, the truth can be unwelcome, especially to the powerful. And Florestan named names. Above all, the name of the provincial governor, Don Pizarro. That's very dangerous. One day, Florestan vanished. No one had seen or heard from him nor knew where he might have gone. Not his family, nor his friends. And certainly not the state police run by none other than Don Pizarro. In response to Leonora's anxious questions, Pizarro suggested her husband must have died. And then, silence. The interminable silence of official indifference and public fear. Over a year passed and still no husband. Leonora's waiting bred anger. Her anger sparked action. Pizarro claimed Florestan had died. But what if his had been a living death? What if he were a prisoner lost in the maze of Pizarro's vast prison? What if Leonora could penetrate its dark secrets and see for herself? And so, disguised as a young man, Leonora has found work with Rocco, the prison warden. This masquerade is a stupid business, but Leonora must brazen it out, even if it has led Marcellina to fall in love with her. What other chance remains? The four of them, Marcellina, Leonora, Rocco, and Giacchino, caught by their strange intertwining destinies, share bewilderment and wonder. Time stands still. And the fragile human heart is laid bare. Rocco is shrewd. He realizes love won't be the only thing Fidelio and Marcellina will need. Something else has to go along with it. Something he knows very well. Money.
Hat man nicht auch Gold bei Leben, kann man nicht ganz glücklich sein. Das Leben, mancher Kummer stellt sich ein, mancher Kummer stellt sich ein. Doch wenn's in den Taschen fein klingert und rot, da hält man das Schicksal gefangen und wacht und Liebe verschafft das Tod und stillt das kühnste Verlangen, das kühnste Verlangen und stille das kühnste Verlangen. Das klingt wie ein Knäckfehlsohn, es ist ein schönes, schönes Ding, das Gut, das Gut. Es ist ein schönes Ding, das Gott, ein goldenes Gott, das Gott, das Gott. Wenn sich nicht mit nichts verbindet, ist gleich die Summe klein. Wer bei Tisch nur Liebe findet, wird nach Tische hungrig sein.
Leonora's perilous masquerade cannot continue much longer. She must act. She asks Rocco to let her help him the next time he goes down into the dungeon. It is the one place Rocco always visits alone. Why? Because Don Pizarro, the governor, has expressly forbidden that anyone join him, and Don Pizarro pays well. So Rocco refuses her request, but she will not be put off. Reluctantly, the warden shares a secret. A mysterious prisoner has been sequestered down below for almost 2 years. No one but Rocco is allowed to see him. Leonora pales. Can it be? Not noticing, Rocco rambles on. Well, whoever it is, it's none of my business. Besides, the man has been put on reduced rations. He'll be dead before too long. Leonora implores Rocco to let her join him. And Marcelina points out that it's only proper for Fidelio to help his future father-in-law. Rocco hesitates. But he is less Pizarro's flunky than a doting father. He will take Fidelio with him.
Gut, Sädchen, gut, hab immer Mut, hab immer Mut, dann wird's dir auch gelingen. Das Herz wird hart durch Gegenwart bei fürchterlichen Dingen.
Thank you.
auf der Hut, dann geht es gut. Der Schiff ist hier, für eure Seelen.
Don't let that jaunty march deceive you. To its four-square tune, troops have arrived, lots of them, armed with bayonets. At their head is Don Pizarro, who's prepared to use them on the slightest pretext. A man like Pizarro does not get where he is by being polite. Pizarro is ruthless, but he's not all-powerful. At this very moment, in fact, his fate hangs in the balance, and his secret captive, Don Florestan, will decide it. Rumors have reached the powers to be that Pizarro has exceeded his authority by suppressing dissent. A surprise inspection of the prison is being planned by his superior, Don Fernando. Now, Florestan was a great friend of this Fernando. If Fernando were suddenly to discover that Florestan had been held here secretly, how foolish Pizarro had been to use half measures. What cowardice has made him merely jail his enemy? Some time still remains. The problem can yet be solved quickly and easily by murder. At its thought, a thrill of power surges through Pizarro. Nothing like a nice sharp dagger to make a man feel invincible.
Thank you.
aus dem Weg zu räumen.
O Herr!
Denn Stade liegt daran, den bösen Untertan schnell, schnell aus dem Weg zu räumen.
O Herr!
Ich sag mal,
o Herr!
Ich sag mal,
für darf die Glühe, will ich leben, so ist böse, was geschehen. Ich nehm mir Zeit, das Leben, nach
Sein Tönen halt den Brüder.
Winter has ended. The sun at long last breaks free of the clouds and shines with springtime freshness. Leonora convinces Rocco to let the prisoners out into the yard. It is such a little thing to share with them, the gentle blessings of nature. After months cramped inside their cells, the prisoners, their steps unsure, their faces wan, edge toward the light and its precious warmth. Not even the guns of Pizarro's troops can stifle the rebirth of their common hope, their dream, freedom.
Thank you. Oh, Thank you.
What does it take to break a man? Not much. Rip him from family and friends, from work and love. Throw him down into an airless pit with just enough food to keep him breathing and wait. It won't be long before he's at your feet begging for mercy. Most men, but not all. Some are different. Some with nothing left to fight for, with nothing left to fight with, still cling fast to that slender thread of their resistance. They'd rather die than capitulate. And on the scaffold, they still would shout their no. Don Florestan is such a man. In the gloomy, muddy pit that serves as his cell, weighed down with chains, he seems at first a bizarre apparition, a ghostly, animated skeleton. But do not be deceived. Though barely able to move, he's very much alive. Despite punishment, despite privation, he does not give up. He does not forget. In the abyss, he holds tight to his humanity.
vom Säuseln. Und ist nicht mein Grab mir erhellet? Ich sehe wie ein Engel im rosigen Duft sie trösten vor Seite mich stellet. Ein Engel Leonoren, Leonoren, der Göttin sogleich, der führt mich zur Freiheit ins himmlische Reich. Nun spür ich mich linde, samt säuselnde Luft. Ich seh wie ein Engel im rosigen Duft, ein Engel sie trösten zur Seite mich stellet. Ein Engel Leonoren, Leonoren der Garten sogleich, der führt mich zur Freiheit mit himmlischer Reich, zur Freiheit mit himmlischer Reich, der führt mich zur Freiheit mit himmlischer Reich, zur Freiheit mit himmlischer Reich.
Kalt ist es in diesem unterirdischen Gewölbe.
Das ist natürlich. Es ist ja tief.
Ich glaubte schon, wir würden den Eingang gar nicht finden.
Da ist er.
Er scheint ganz ohne Bewegung.
Vielleicht ist er tot.
Ihr meint es?
Nein, nein, er schläft. Das müssen wir benutzen und gleich ins Werk gehen. Wir haben keine Zeit zu verlieren.
Es ist unmöglich, seine Züge zu unterscheiden. Gott stehe bei, wenn er es ist.
Drinnen ist die Zisterne, von der ich dir gesagt habe. Wir brauchen nicht viel zu graben, um an die Öffnung zu kommen. Gib mir die Haut und du stelle dich hierher. Stirbst? Fürchtest du dich?
Oh nein, es ist nur so kalt.
Mach sofort! Im Arbeiten wird es schon warm werden.
Frisch gegraben, es fällt nicht lang.
A simple moment, but a terrible one. Leonora stands, sweaty, covered with grime from digging the grave of the man who may be her husband. Not far from her, through the musty, fetid air, she sees the captive stir. He speaks. That voice! Her every impulse cries out, God, it is he! She would run to Florestan, embrace him, comfort him, and take him far, far from this hell. But no, she's silent. Even though her heart may break, she must stand firm. She must wait. One player is yet missing, Don Pizarro. Without him, a rescue from this armed camp can never succeed. Cautiously, she checks her one protection against his force. A pistol hidden underneath her vest. The prisoner begs for water. Leonora rushes forward to give him some. Florestan sees only the disguise, a youngster, head averted, strangely moved, who with trembling hands offers relief to a doomed man. And through this simple, decent act, Florestan is given hope.
Oh. Thank you.
hast du getan zu rühren? Nur noch ein Augenblick auf diesen Ort.
Meilen, so wie der große Ost nach nun.
Upon absence without desire, upon naked solitude, upon the tread of death, I write your name. Upon health regained, upon vanished risk, upon hope without remembrance, I write your name. And through the power of a word, I take up my life again. I was born to know you, born to name you, Liberty!
Oh,
Dienste und tat so brav betreue Dienste, dass mich zum einen sie erkommt. Der Unmensch holt in dieser Stunde und zieht an Flores an den Chor. Sie mit uns im Bunde.
Sei das Licht, der Ort zu verwenden, in den Gemeinden zu Love has proved stronger than stone walls and iron bars. Leonora is reunited with her husband Florestan, while the evil Don Pizarro becomes the sole occupant of his own prison. The exultant ending to Fidelio by Ludwig van Beethoven. In this concert version of Beethoven's only opera, presented at Toronto's Roy Thomson Hall, we heard Eva Maria Bunshu as Leonora, Ben Heppner was Florestan, Alan Monk, Don Pizarro, Gary Relier, Don Fernando, Edith Weens was Marcelina, Benoit Boutet, Jacquino, and John McCurdy, Rocco. The Toronto Symphony and the Toronto Mendelssohn Choir were under the direction of Günter Herbig. The narrative links, written by Ian Strasfogel, were read by Werner Klemperer. Gary Relier is one of this country's most versatile performers. The bass baritone is a regular guest with major Canadian orchestras and opera companies.